To be honest, we are not great at proactive planning, particularly in the US. So part of the issue of just transition is that if we plan now, in 10 years, we actually will have a just transition. But what you're seeing now is kind of like the last dying gasp of this industry that is kind of, you know, really digging their nails in and trying to extract every last element of coal, oil, and gas. I can talk a little bit about an example that I think is a good and instructive one, about Diablo Canyon, which is in Northern California. It's a nuclear power plant. And the operating utility, PG&E, decided not to renew their operating license because the cost of solar was so cheap that it became economically unviable to continue the nuclear power plant. So it's proactive in the sense that it's not happening tomorrow, but it will be in a 7 to 8 year horizon. And so when it became clear that Diablo Canyon would not continue, a diverse coalition came together that included PG&E and included the union that represented the workers in the plant, IBEW, the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, local community groups, because, you know, a lot of it's in San Luis Obispo, a lot of the community, that the money that comes from the nuclear power plant really funds things like schools and infrastructure, and environmental organizations and anti-nuclear organizations. And they came together with this plan that had a worker transition plan and had a community transition plan, and then also required replacement, that you would replace the nuclear power with a renewable energy. They took that plan to the California Public Utilities Commission, which approved parts of it. So a diminished worker retention plan, no support for the community, and no guarantee that the nuclear energy would be replaced by renewables. The reason why you need a diverse coalition and kind of from the ground up planning is that instead of accepting that reduced and diminished package, the coalition went to the California State Legislature, and they introduced a bill forcing the PUC to adopt the original transition plan, which is much more just and much better for everybody. So now, when Diablo Canyon retires, they have a worker retention plan that will have a tax revenue replacement for the community, and they also have a guaranteed replacement of renewable energy to replace that nuclear energy. And I think that kind of thing is what we want to do. We want to engage in more proactive planning. You know, in contrast, for instance, there was a refinery that blew up in outside Philadelphia, and because they were in crisis, right, they had to immediately deal with this consequence. Workers then immediately turn, environmentalists start to fight, because everybody is in a moment of stress and a moment of, there are really immediate needs that are not being met. So a much better approach is that understanding that we have to really decline this fossil fuel infrastructure. We know that now. So now we can begin the planning processes so people don't end up making decisions in crises.